want to know what polio is all about, how can we transmit it, and how to prevent it, then keep on watching. Hello everyone, my name is Malay and welcome back to my channel. Today we are very privileged because with us is the Department of Health Region 10 head of the infectious diseases cluster. Without further delay, please welcome Dr. Ian Gonzalez. Dr. Ian today will talk about polio, how can we transmit it, and how can we prevent it. Doc, thank you so much for saying yes to this interview. Doc, can you tell us what polio is all about? Is it really contagious, and how can we transmit it?
Okay, so polio is a infectious disease caused by a virus, okay, the poliovirus. So there are three types of poliovirus, types 1, 2, and 3. Type 2 has been eradicated globally already, no? So meaning there is no wild type 2 poliovirus circulating around. We only have type 1 and 3. Polio is a very contagious disease, and it is transmitted through the fecal-oral route. So what does that mean? It's not like the flu that you can get it when someone coughs or sneezes at you. No, it's something that can be transmitted when we eat or when we drink contaminated food or water. No, so that makes certain people more vulnerable, especially the children, because they're the ones who play with the dirt, you know, put things in their mouth. So that's why polio mainly affects the younger age groups.
Oh, so just to summarize it, Doc, no, the people at risk are the children,
yeah, specifically kids less than 5 years of age.
Oh, okay. Doc, what is an outbreak, and as of today, what is the status of Region 10 and Misamis Oriental in particular, as much as polio is concerned? Is it considered an outbreak already?
Yeah, we have a national declaration for the polio outbreak. So what's different about polio, for example, in contrast with dengue, because we also recently had a dengue outbreak. Polio is already an eradicated disease, which means that supposed to be we are not having any case in the Philippines. So even one human case of polio is already considered an outbreak. So as of now, in the Philippines, we have 8 cases, 7 of which are in Mindanao. So although there are no cases in Region 10, we have cases in the neighboring region, which is Barm. So we have a lot of border areas between Barm and Region 10. And so the response for this outbreak is to immunize all children in Mindanao as well as in NCR, where we also have one case.
Okay. Doc, you mentioned earlier that it's in oral fecal route. So if we also get from water, is it not safe to swim in rivers and swimming pools?
Theoretically, it is safe for as long as we're vaccinated. No? So that's why we advocate vaccinating all of the eligible children. So in Region 10, our target is 584,000 children under 5 years of age, and we hope to reach at least 95% of these children by the end of this week.
Okay, Doc. How about our food, Doc? Is it safe to eat vegetables and fish from water? How do I say this? Affected or water with poliovirus?
It is safe for as long as it's cooked well. No, so okay. Just like other diseases that we get from food, like the common diarrheal diseases, for polio, we just have to cook the food well to deactivate the virus. But most importantly, aside from cooking the food well, is the vaccination. Because we cannot assure that the food is well prepared all the time, we cannot assure that the water that we drink is always clean. We cannot always be assured that those who prepare the food practice good hygiene. So it pays to have our children vaccinated.
Oh, okay. Doc, you already mentioned about vaccination. So just to be clear, I would like to ask you this question. How can we prevent the spread and make sure that we are protected from poliovirus?
Okay, so knowing that polio is spread through the fecal-oral route, so number one is to practice good hygiene. So part of that is washing our hands before, after eating, after using the toilet, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, to part of our DOH program is to have zero open defecation. So people have to use toilets. You'd be surprised that a lot of places in the Philippines, people still don't use toilets. The third and most important is vaccination. No? Without vaccination, we still have more and more cases.
So, Doc, who are the people needed to be vaccinated?
So, for polio, our target is all children less than 5 years of age.
Mm. Do we have such thing as polio vaccine overdosage?
Okay, so that's a good question. For polio vaccine, there is no risk of overdose. So that's why for this immunization, we call it supplemental immunization. It is on top of the previous routine immunization. So even if your child has completed vaccinations before when he was a baby, they still can get and should get the supplemental polio vaccine at no risk of any overdose.
Okay. Doc, I've noticed on social media the flooding of the Department of Health employees. They are posting about the Sabayang Patak Contra Polio. Can you please tell us what is this Sabayang Patak Contra Polio campaign is all about?
Okay, so the Sabayang Patak Contra Polio is the Philippine government through the Department of Health's response to the polio outbreak. So because we have cases in NCR and in Mindanao, we have a simultaneous or Sabayang vaccination campaign in the entire Mindanao and in NCR. So the first round is from November 25 to December 7. So we're currently finishing up on that one. And the second round will be on January 20 to February 5, 2020.
Do you have any message to the public as regards to polio?
Okay, so polio is a very dangerous disease. It can lead to paralysis, permanent paralysis of children. However, to avoid it, it's very simple. Practice good hygiene and most importantly, get vaccinated. The polio vaccine is safe, effective, and free. So if you haven't gotten it yet, or if your kids haven't gotten it yet, go to your nearest health center and get them vaccinated.
So now you know, guys, let's prevent the spread of polio and let's end polio together. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, comment down below, and don't forget to hit that notification bell icon beside the subscribe button so you won't miss my next video. Once again, this is Melai. Thank you so much for watching. See you around. Bye! Thank you so much.